Hello, I am Enrique Barra and we are going to see the DevTools. DevTools or developer tools or web developer tools is just a set of tools that the browsers such as Chrome or Firefox provides us just to facilitate web development. We will be able to see the web content, the page content, the HTML tags, the styles, the network, what happened. We have a JavaScript console. We will be able to see the source files with all the JavaScript. We will be able to stop the code and debug it just to see the variables and any function and all the content and execute step by step what is happening to see what is happening and many, many other possibilities. How can we access them? Well, in our browser, usually in Chrome and Firefox, you can click on F12 or right-click and then inspect element. In Safari, you will have to turn on the development menu and then follow these small instructions, okay? This is how they look on Chrome. They are very, very useful, as I say. They have many tabs here and they by default appear at the bottom or of our page. But with this menu here, we will be able to move them to the left, to the right, or wherever or even pop up. For React, we will have a special extension, a Chrome extension, that can be installed from this URL. You just write React Developer Tools on Chrome, if you don't want to write this ugly URL. And you get a special tab here in the Developer Tools. It will show us the components of our page, the React components of our page. Okay? We will also be able to see the state, the props, and any other React content. For Angular, we have another one that is called Auguri. It is very similar to the one in React, but for Angular, we will see the components and the properties and these kind of things of our Angular application. And if our app includes Redux, we will have another one that is called Redux DevTools, and with this one we will be able to test the Redux architecture and we will be able to travel in time as we can see in this GIF here. We will be able to go forward and backward in the state of our application. Okay, this is everything, let's see how they work. If we have in a browser an application like this one, that is in fact the one that we are going to build with React and Angular in this MOOC, we can right click and then inspect element or just F12. It will open the developer tools. We can see now in a first view that we have here this button to change the layout to a mobile or a tablet PC or whatever. This other one is just to get different elements of the page and see them into this first tab, that is the elements tab. The elements tab just indicates the HTML content of the page and we can even modify it directly here. You can see that I can click on this one to select it directly on the page or I can go selecting them here and they will be selected on the page. And as I say, we can, for example, with a double click, modify it directly on the fly and we can see the result. Of course, this is not saved on the file. If we like how it is, we should go to our IDE, item, Sublime or whatever and get these changes. As I told you, in this button on my back, you can move the developer tools to another part or even pop them up. Now we can see on the left part they are working the same way, but now we can see that also in this column we have the styles that can be also modified directly on the fly. You can see the structure, the box extractor, the different style properties, CSS that each component has, each HTML has. The second tab is the console, where we can see the JavaScript errors of our application and it's a JavaScript console. So I can say var x equals 9, x and it tells me 9. X plus 0. 9. X plus 9. 18. And so on. So it's a JavaScript console where you can test your JavaScript code. Then we have the source tab where we have our source files. For example, the HTML, but also, and more importantly, the content, the JavaScript files that will depend on our application structure. In this case, it is React and Redux, but what I want to show you here is that I can open a file and we can stop the code. So when the user interacts with the application, we can see what is happening, we can execute one step, another step, we can see the values, just putting my mouse on the variable. You can even open a console, show console, just to execute more commands. Okay. So you can do many, many things. And to continue, we can remove the breakpoint or add it again. And for to continue, just play the button. This is very, very used functionality and we will be using it a lot. Then you have other tabs like network, performance, just to optimize your application. And finally, if you have them installed, you can see Redux and React and Angular extensions of your web developer tools. Okay, hope you like them and you use them a lot because they are very, very useful. I invite you to enter any web page and modify it and start working and playing with them to learn how to use them. Thank you very much.